Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Brode, Medical Director of the Post-COVID-19 Program at UT Health Austin. Today, I'll guide you through an easy way to check for postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, also called POTS, at home. This is a common condition in long COVID that I believe all patients should be screened for. Here, I'm going to show you how to measure your orthostatic vital signs, which is a series of heart rate and blood pressure measurements taken in different positions, laying down, sitting, and standing. Taking these measurements at home isn't an official way to diagnose POTS, but as a screening test, it can provide a lot of information to share with your doctor and help guide whether you need specific treatments or further testing. So let's get started. First of all, gather your materials. You will need a blood pressure monitor. Both a wrist or an arm monitor work perfectly fine, as we are interested in how the blood pressure changes, not necessarily if they are perfectly accurate. You'll also need a device to measure your heart rate, like a pulse oximeter, a fitness tracker, or a blood pressure monitor if it has that heart rate feature. You'll also need a place to lie down, like your bed, and a wall to lean on for standing measurements. This test will take about 20 minutes total to complete. To ensure accurate results, avoid drinking excessive water or eating high-salt foods for 24 hours before doing the test, and try not to have any caffeine within a few hours of testing. The test is most accurate if it is performed while you are not taking any medications that affect either your heart rate or blood pressure. Examples of these are high blood pressure medications, beta blockers, or stimulant medications. Generally, it is recommended to hold your medications for 24 hours before doing the testing, but it is crucial to make sure you consult your healthcare provider to make sure you can safely hold any medications or to determine if certain medications should be stopped for longer periods to ensure accurate results. So let's do your first baseline measurement laying down. To do this, lie down in a quiet and comfortable spot for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, measure and record your heart rate and blood pressure. This is your baseline reading. An example, your heart rate is 70 beats per minute and your blood pressure is 118 over 70 millimeters of mercury. In the video description, we link to a handout that has these instructions, and on the back page, we have a table where you can write down these results. For your second measurement, you need to be sitting down. So sit upright and rest another 5 minutes with your feet on the ground. Take your heart rate and blood pressure readings again and write them down in the table. For your third and fourth measurements, you should be standing up against the wall using the NASA lean method. To do this, stand up against the wall and get yourself into the NASA lean position. Rest your upper back and head lightly against a wall. Keep your feet about 6 inches from the wall and relax your arms at your sides. Avoid leaning your buttocks against the wall to ensure a proper position. After 5 minutes in this position, take and record your heart rate and your blood pressure. Stay in the same position for another 5 minutes, which is a total of 10 minutes standing. At the end of 10 minutes, take and record your heart rate and blood pressure again. During this test, write down any symptoms you experience, like dizziness, lightheadedness, or heart racing. Next, let's talk about interpreting the results. It's important to note, once again, that this is a screening test that we have simplified so people can do it in their own home. If you're having trouble testing yourself or you need very precise results, a full NASA lean test can be performed by a healthcare provider, or you can request a tilt table test, although that requires specialized equipment that is not widely available. Nevertheless, these home readings can be very informative. After completing your readings, look for these key changes. An increase in heart rate of 30 beats per minute or more within the first 10 minutes of standing suggests that you have POTS. A drop in blood pressure, such as a decrease in 20 millimeters of mercury in the systolic number, that's the top one, may indicate orthostatic hypotension. Both of these conditions are types of autonomic nervous system problems that are common in long COVID, but they are distinct conditions. The autonomic nervous system controls all your automatic functions, like heart rate, blood pressure, digestion, and even temperature regulation. While both POTS and orthostatic hypotension are treatable by your medical provider, they require different approaches. This is why recording both your heart rate and blood pressure is essential to ensure accurate diagnosis and make sure you get the appropriate treatment. Overall, you should perform this test twice. Once on a good day where you don't have many long COVID symptoms or you're not experiencing a flare-up. You should do it a second time on a bad day when you are experiencing a lot of long COVID symptoms, especially dizziness or heart racing. POTS can sometimes only appear during symptomatic periods, so testing both days provides valuable information. Record your results in the table and share them with your healthcare provider. You should contact your provider if you're having concerns or any unusual symptoms during the testing. So thank you for joining me today. I hope this will be helpful in your path to recovery.